So if I start taking it so seriously that, okay, this person thinks like that of me or whatever, and if I take it as a fact that this is me, and I take it as a reality that whatever this person is saying about me is me, but it's not the fact. So it's fine. I do respect everyone who have opinions about me. That's fine. But it doesn't affect me because I know that's not the fact, because people might know, not know me. So like personally, so that's okay.
A multi-talented youth icon, actor, model, and a highly engaged social media influencer. Her debut film was Loafer, a super hit Telugu movie. In 2016, she appeared in a music video, Befikra, along with Tiger Shroff, which caught the imagination of public. The next film she starred was MS Dhoni, The Untold Story. Her performance was highly appreciated in the film and was also on the box office hit. Disha also shared screen space with Jackie Chan in Kung Fu Yoga. Featuring in Dabbu Ratnani Calendar was another highlight in her promising career. Born in Bareilly, Disha Patani is one of the most engaged stars in social media. So here we have Disha Patani and calling Shamik, head of India and APAC for EscapeX, the New York-based company which has developed the Disha Patani official app, and Kulbi Sajdev, India and Southeast Asia leader of EscapeX.
Actually, it's a pleasure for me to be a part of this beautiful app. I always talk to all my fans on Insta. And I have many groups actually in Insta where you have these young kids who are like 16, 17, and they're talking to me about their exams, they're talking to me about their life and how they're struggling, the teenage. So for me, it's such a brilliant thing that I'm getting a platform where I can actually talk to them one-on-one, because sometimes it's difficult. These websites like Insta or Facebook doesn't allow me to go onto that level, because you know, you have so many pages, you have so many people on Insta, so sometimes it's really, really, you don't actually realize who are the important ones and who are actually your real fans. So it's giving me a platform. It's going to be much more private, and I'm also going to be uploading all the exclusive pictures and videos and behind the scenes, so that's going to be fun. We also have a lot of cool contests, so you know, like through contests we can also make sure, like, you know, these are the top three ranking fans, and I would love to meet them as well. So we have a lot of cool concept, and I'm really, really excited, and I'm very happy that I'm a part of it, and I'm actually doing something like this, because this would give me a closer reach to my fans and actually friends. I don't want to call them fans, friends. So yeah, if I am launching an app, mere pe bahut responsibility hai that, you know, I have to make sure that I talk to them, because what's the motive of the app? If I can't take out time for people who are actually loving me so much and giving me so much love, then it won't work. End of the day, it's all about interaction and, you know, knowing those people who love you so much and support you. So I think it depends from person to person, how much time you give, how much love you give, you'll get it back. I feel we have a lot of contests that I don't know that other apps had. Will you agree?
No, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, we have a lot of contests, and you know, through contests, you can always come to know that who's your biggest fan, you know, and you can also send them merchandise. You can also send them gifts, which are personalized. And I can also meet them, which is a cool thing, because, you know, you can throw a contest. But what do you see on Insta or Facebook? You don't have these kind of things where you can actually meet your fans. So through the contest, if you win the contest, if you're actually a real fan, you can actually also meet me. And I would love to do that, because, you know, I would like to know how these people are, how these kids are. And there's also a lot of, I think that's the...
One of the key things, like I mentioned before, is the fact that you will have, as a fan, you will have the ability to pin your post so that Disha can see it. You can't do that anywhere else, okay? Second, you can't earn virtual currency anywhere else. So these are key elements, right? I mean, if I'm spending time there, I mean, I can tell you there are people who spend hours and hours on the app and comment, and they may get into like Instas and the Twitters and the Facebooks of the world, but they don't gain anything out of it, right? It's just a one-way street. Here, not only you are gaining virtual currency, but you also have the ability to put yourself up there, pin your post so that Disha can see it, and then get a reply from Disha. You don't have it anywhere else, and that's the most unique thing about it.
Once you're in,
as I said, that I always speak to my fans, and I have these crazy groups and crazy kids talking to me every day. I speak to them. I make sure at least I send them a heart or a hi or a morning or a night. So every day I'm still doing the same thing. But sometimes I feel, okay, I'm only speaking to people who are my fan clubs. So right now, I don't know, okay, someone who can't make a fan club right now won't have that reach because I won't know that that person also like takes me as an idol or is a crazy fan of mine. So I'm still doing the same. I think, yeah, it's a bigger responsibility for sure, but I have a team for that. So that's why I have a big team. I have a responsible team. So I think that will be helpful. If I'm writing down something and this is my idea or this is my imagination, it won't be a fact. So if I start taking it so seriously that, okay, this person thinks like that of me or whatever, and if I take it as a fact that this is me and I take it as a reality that whatever this person is saying about me is me, but it's not the fact. So it's fine. I do respect everyone who have opinions about me. That's fine. But it doesn't affect me because I know that's not the fact because people might not know me so like personally. So that's okay.
Hi. So I wanted to ask, since you're a public figure and you're a celebrity and you can see that there are cases that, you know, when a celebrity shares everything, almost everything on social media, there's also the cause that there are stalkers. So how is this app preventing you from those stalkers? Because then you never know. I'm a fan, but I'm also a stalker. I'm getting the benefit.
I'm so sorry. Isn't, if you're a fan, you're a stalker. That's the thing.
Yeah,
if I like someone, I stalk that person.
Access.
Oh, see, it depends. There's always a fine line between your personal life and a fine line between your professional line. So I'm not breaking that line. Okay, I'm going to be super friendly and I'm going to be expressing. But there's always going to be this fine line for my private life, which I'm not going to expose because I feel your private or personal life should stay private or personal. Bollywood, I love Priyanka. I love her. And she's just so confident. Actor, I love Shah Rukh. And when I was young, I used to be a huge fan of Ranbir.
So my question to you is, it's been just 6 months since you have made a debut in Bollywood and you already have an app. That's like super achievement. So how do you feel about that?
No. I got super lucky. I've been very... fortunate for everything, the kind of work I've been getting, and thanks to them for approaching me and for feeling that I could take this forward, I could take this responsibility. So yeah, all the credit to them.
By the way, I'm a huge fan of yours, and as we are speaking, I've already started downloading the app.
Really?
Oh yeah. So I hope I'll be reading a lot about
top rank.
Rank yourself. You might just win.
Sure.
Yeah, we're going to announce a very exciting contest soon.
Sure.
Maybe you're the lucky one. So
I'll take part in.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everyone. And with this, we end the press conference. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.